Barnabas by Charles Dickens. Audiobook 44x48. He said that, being shunned by everyone who knew his calling, even by people of the level of the lowest and most wretched grade, and finding, when he joined the rioters, that the men he acted with had no suspicion of it, which I believe is true enough, for a poor fool of an old prentice of mine was one of them, he had kept his own counsel, up to the time of his being taken and put in jail. Very discreet of Mr. Dennis, observed Sir John with a slight yawn, though still with the utmost affability, but except for your admirable and lucid manner of telling it, which is perfect not very interesting to me. When, pursued the locksmith, quite unabashed and wholly regardless of these interruptions, when he was taken to the jail, he found that his fellow prisoner, in the same room, was a young man, Hugh by name, a leader in the riots, who had been betrayed and given up by himself. From something which fell from this unhappy creature in the course of the angry words they had at meeting, he discovered that his mother had suffered the death to which they both are now condemned. The time is very short. Sir John, page 1.022/1.119. The knight laid down his paper fan, replaced his cup upon the table at his side, and, saving for the smile that lurked about his mouth, looked at the locksmith with as much steadiness as the locksmith looked at him. They have been in prison now a month. One conversation led to many more, and the hangman soon found, from a comparison of time and place and dates, that he had executed the sentence of the law upon this woman, himself. She had been tempted by want, as so many people are, into the easy crime of passing forged notes. She was young and handsome, and the traders who employ men, women, and children in this traffic, looked upon her as one who was well adapted for their business, and who would probably go on without suspicion for a long time. But they were mistaken, for she was stopped in the commission of her very first offence, and died for it. She was of gypsy blood, Sir John. It might have been the effect of a passing cloud which obscured the sun, and cast a shadow on his face, but the knight turned deadly pale. Still he met the locksmith's eye, as before. She was of gypsy blood, Sir John, repeated Gabriel, and had a high, free spirit. This, and her good looks, and her lofty manner, interested some gentlemen who were easily moved by dark eyes, and efforts were made to save her. They might have been successful, if she would have given them any clue to her history.